So, dear children, good morning to all of you. I hope you all will be practicing how to read the lesson. मुझे आशा है कि आप लोग सब लोग पढ़ने में एंजॉय कर रहे होंगे, क्योंकि जब तक आप किसी काम को एंजॉय नहीं करेंगे, यू विल नॉट बी परफेक्ट. So let's start from the next paragraph. Ricky and Jonak built a bird bath, and their sisters Monpi and Tinky filled with water. The birds enjoyed splashing about in the cool water. The month was January. The Bihu festival was fast approaching. There would be much feasting and merriment during the festival. Each household would build a mezi, a pile of firewood stacked neatly together in their backyard. On the first morning of the festival, the mezi would be set alight, invoking the blessing of Agni, the god of fire. Let's build a champion mezi this year, Ricky suggested a few days before the festival. Jonak, Monpi, and Tinky warmed to the idea. Monpi, the most practical one, saw the difficulties ahead. But where will we get so much wood from? Father might buy some firewood, but that will be just enough for a tiny mezi. True, agreed Tinky. Mother uses a gas stove in the kitchen. There's no firewood in the house. For a while, the children pondered over the problem. Then Ricky's gaze fell on the jamun tree and his eyes lit up. We can chop down some of the biggest branches of the jamun tree, he exclaimed. It will provide us with so much firewood that we can easily build a giant mezi. Jonak clapped Ricky on the back. Good idea, he said approvingly. Our mezi would be the envy of all our friends in the neighborhood. Monpi and Tinky were equally enthusiastic. How could they cut down those enormous branches? If their parents knew, they would surely be angry. And even if they were four of them, cutting down a tree so large would take them at least 2 days. But the chance came one day just before the festival. Their grandmother had fallen ill in Calcutta, and she wanted their parents with her. Before they left, their mother gave them a very clear last minute instructions. Don't forget to get the milk in the morning, and remember to do your homework every day, and if you have time, go to the woods and pick up twigs and sticks that have fallen on the ground. You can add that to the wood we will buy for the mezi. The following day, happily for the children, was a Saturday. Borrowing an extra axe from their neighbors, they divided up the duties. Ricky and Jonak, being older, took on the heavy job of the cutting the branches. Monpi and Tinky were to stock the wood in neat piles on the ground. Ricky climbed to one of the top branches. It wasn't easy getting there, but he managed it. When he had tucked himself between the huge trunk and the thick branch, he looked around. What a magnificent view! There in the distance, the deep, placid river flowed past the temple. A train went tuk-tuk-tuk, leaving a trail of ash, grey smoke. In the jamun tree itself, birds twittered happily. But he was forgetting the mezi. Picking up the axe, he began a systematic chop-chop close to his body. Suddenly, he could hear a shrill, high-pitched scream. It was the hawk kite that used to nest in the tree. He could only see one. Did that mean the other had gone up to hunt for the food, for fledglings? Were there little ones in the nest? Curious, he climbed a little further, and sure enough, there were two nearly whole grown chicks. In fact, they were so big that they looked almost like their parents, only lighter in color. "Hey, Jonak," cried Ricky, climbing down. There is a nest with two young hawk kites here. And look, Ricky, there. There's an enormous beehive. Must be 2 years at least. Nor this sight. And think of all the efforts that's gone into the making of that beehive. And there must be many other nests that are used regularly by the birds. See, that's the hole that the barbet uses. And look, this hole is obviously a squirrel's home. I can see peanuts inside. They climbed down slowly. Down below, Moonpie and Tinky were gathering whatever sticks and twigs they could find. They were surprised to see the brothers down so soon. "What happened?" they asked, somewhat embarrassed. Ricky explained, "You see, this tree is a home for so many creatures that we couldn't bring ourselves to cut it down." "Oh, that's not fair," cried the youngsters together. "What will happen to our Meji?" "Well, let's think," said Jonak. "We can't cut the tree, that's obvious. How would we feel if someone burnt our house down?" Said Moonpie, looking thoughtful. The four of them sat in the shade of the tree, leaning against the gnarled trunk. Finally, Ricky spoke. "I think we have to forget our plans for a big Meji this year. Maybe next year." Jonak had an idea. "Look, in our class, we have a social forestry project. They are giving us sababul saplings to plant in February, March. I think I'll ask them for some. These trees are specially grown to be cut so that older trees can be saved," Ricky said. "What a good idea, Jonak. Get some saplings. We'll plant them along the boundary wall. In 2 years' time, they are grown, we can cut them down and have a grand Meji." When their parents returned, Moonpie and Tinky told them about how the jamun tree had nearly become a Meji. Father Ishmael, "I'm glad you didn't cut it down. Think what would have happened. You and your friends climb the tree, eat its fruit, play in its shade. If it weren't there, our courtyard would be silent." He stopped for a while, then continued. "It takes years and years for a tree to grow, mature, bear flowers and fruits. To cut one down takes just a few hours." Then he smiled and said, "Come, I brought each of you a gift. They are lying in the backyard." The four youngsters rushed to the back of the house. To their delight, four saplings, one each of jamun, mango, guava, and jackfruit, were propped up in polythene bags against the bamboo fencing. To their delight, four saplings, one each of jamun, mango, guava, and jackfruit, were propped up in polythene bags against the bamboo fencing. The children lost their time in digging four holes in the four corners of the backyard and planting the saplings. They promised to water the plants morning and evening. It would take some time for the saplings to grow up into trees, and these, they decided, they wouldn't cut down. They would grow into big, tall trees. The eucalyptus and sababul, they could be cut. That night, as the children got ready to go to bed, Jonak said, "We may have a small Meji this year, but I'm glad we didn't cut the jamun tree." The others nodded happily.